Take one. Yeah, I got nothing. Hey everybody, good morning. Welcome back to the Shug and Boog channel. I am Boog. Shug is inside resting. Not resting, but cleaning up around the house. I am doing one of our first mods today. It's weird how you start to do something and you're like, hey, well, maybe someone else would be interested in this. And you're like, all right, I guess I'll get out my phone. I guess I'll record. So today I will be taking the liquid propane cover, and I'll show it to you here in a second. There is a place where the cotter pins hook into the stem to hold that particular cover on. We've only had the rig about 2 weeks, and you can already see where there's marks from where we've opened it up and closed it only a few times. So it's kind of scrape marks. It doesn't look all that great, be honest with you. The cotter pins, they're knuckle busters. Every time you try to put them back in, you know, you're trying to pound on a cotter pin. No one likes doing that. So these are going to be easy push button releases. So so kind of excited to share it with everybody. So what I'm going to cut to next is the existing setup. And then after that, I'm going to bring you in and show you what we're going to put on. And then hopefully, fingers crossed, we skip through time, hopefully a very short time, and I'll show you what the new ones look like. So stay tuned and let's get going. Okay, here we are back out at the Soul Horizon made by Intech. Try not to be too long out here. It's a little windy and I know how annoying that can be. So here is our liquid propane cover that has two 20-pound propane tanks behind it. What I was talking about earlier are these cotter pins right here that hold on this cover. So I don't know if you can see them. I'm not gonna zoom in because that would make the camera shake, but the screws are already rusting a little bit. We got the cotter pin, and so we're gonna remove these, and then we're gonna put in some quick release push button latches, I guess they're called. So so show you next is what we're going to be putting in. Okay, we are now back in the garage, ready to start on this little mod. You can see the marks that I was talking about a little bit better in this light. And if we even go in a little closer, we can even see the rust that has been starting to form on the screws. So again, already not very attractive. So now we're gonna go ahead and pan on over to what we're going to be replacing this with. This is a product by Stesham, I believe that is. So what we're gonna have here, this is going to be our quick release. So again, it's gonna look a little bit nicer and shinier than what we got in. And this is going to be the ball onto which it releases. So, and for demonstration purposes and one-handed camera handiwork, so this is what it's gonna look like when it's closed. And when I push on it, it's just gonna come right off. So again, a little bit nicer, a little bit cleaner than the cotter pin situation. Doing measurements, this piece right here is 1.5 inches in diameter. So I went out and purchased a 1.5 inch diameter hole cutting tool. So this should go pretty quickly. Again, I think the hardest part of doing this mod is to make sure that I get this centered on the hole exactly, because that is where it will feed back through the original screws. So that's going to be kind of important. All right, I'm going to start taking off these screws next, and I'll show you what's under there and what our next steps are going to be after that. Okay, so we got those screws removed. I took off the little piece of plastic that was covering it, I guess the scratch guard, and now we're left with a couple holes where the screws were, but those will be covered up by the quick latch release cover. As you can see, the hole in the plastic is much smaller than what we have to drill. That's why I went out and got that bit. What I'm gonna do is, because the plastic cover seemed to be a little bit offset from where the hole actually was, I'm going to take the cover back out to the rig. I'm going to stick the cover back on and the guide screw that comes through the hole. I'm going to make sure that that is true, and that's going to be my starting point. Because like I said, the piece of plastic cover, it was offset just a little bit. So we only got one chance to screw this in right, so I'm going to double check my work before I get to drilling. Okay, we're back out at the RV. And I'm just holding this up with my hand. But you can see where that's slightly offset to the upper part of that original hole that I was talking about. And over here on the left side, that is even more towards the inner part of that hole. So I'm gonna have to take that into consideration when I go to drill these holes, so. Okay, so quick tip from your Uncle Dan. Even though the measurements look like they're going to fit the 1.5-inch hole, I drill that in here, this piece here should automatically just fill in. It was really close. And when you're dealing with thin plastic, like we have on this cover, you don't want to drill or cut any holes more than you need to, right? You just want to try to do it right the first time. So what I did is that on my spare piece of plywood, I went ahead and drilled a hole and I checked it out. So here we go. And it is a tight fit, but that's exactly what I needed to do. So now I feel a little bit more comfortable and confident in what I'm going to drill into the piece of plastic. So that's going to be our next step. So I've been overknown to think certain items as I get closer. In this particular one, I wanted to make sure that when I stick this hole over this one, that I'm going to be exactly centered where I need to be. So what I did is that I took off the ring that I will be installing, put that on there, and then I got out my knife here with the razor. I scored on the inside where I wanted those marks to be. So now I know exactly where I want that, the outer edges of the the bit that I'm going to use to put a hole in the plastic. So I just need to be on the outside of those scratches. So here we go. All right, good news. So went ahead and drilled out the holes for each. I went out and measured it on the RV. Looks like it's going to be a pretty good fit. Next thing is going to be to take this ring. That's going to go on the backside, and then we'll put this other piece through and we will clamp those together. So that's going to be our next step. Little nerve wracking, not going to lie. You know, this is brand new. I'm sure this plastic cover is not cheap to get a replacement. So don't want to screw up our RV the first time I try to do something to it. So yeah, I'm going to get these pieces together and then we will look at the final product and see what it looks like. Okay, so next we need to attach, I screwed on that back ring to hold on the front push part. Next we have several different sizes of these screw threads. Got a handy dandy little Allen wrench. And now these get added into the back to add stability and to lock down those two pieces. Oddly enough, it's kind of intuitive what to do, but there were no instructions with this particular kit. So I've been figuring it out as I've been going along. And this week's video is sponsored by Craftsman. We will get nothing, they will give nothing. Thank you, Craftsman. Okay, so moving on, we have this outer piece. Look at that great camera work where I gotta sit here and pay attention to make sure I'm not in the shot. That's awesome. We got the outer piece installed now. So next we are going to go out to the RV, and next piece of the installation is installing these bad boys. So got a couple screws here. I'm going to try and mimic the current depth that the current placement of the bolts are out there. So try to make it a little easier on myself with less adjustments. So Let's go see how that's gonna go.
Okay, back out of the RV. I'll try and make this quick because it is windy and I know that can sound like crap. So our next step is to remove the existing pins right over here. We're gonna put in our own pins that the new quick release covers should snap into fairly easy. Quick side note, here's our two LP tanks. We've been watching videos for a long time. We've been reading blogs about RVing, and we hear that if you're away from your rig at any given time and there's unscrupulous people around, they might come in and steal your LP tanks. So we just took a little precaution, got a nice little bike lock with a combination. So that is actually chained down to the rig so they can try and come in. If they got big enough cutters, it's gonna be easy, but you know, gotta make them try. So that's it.
All right, so the wind died down for a second. This is exactly what I was talking about. We got the old pin on the right. We got the new one on the left. I've adjusted that first bolt so that it will fit hopefully the same as the old one, and we don't have to do much adjustment. So we're gonna try that.
Okay, again, still windy, gonna be quick, successful installation of the pins. Now is the final test. We'll bring the cover plate out and see if we snap in. Okay, so we got the first test run. Went ahead and lined up the holes, put them in, and we are successful. Honey, I did not screw up the brand new, pretty expensive toy. Yay for me. I do have some adjustments to do though. As we can see here, there's quite a gap. So I'm going to open this back up, make the adjustments, and see how snug we can get that. Woohoo! Good days. Okay, so good news. We got a successful fit. Now we have two quick releases set up on the RV as opposed to this knuckle busting, rusty, scraped up, draconian piece of equipment. So successful there. All right, guys, successful installation of our quick release pins over our dual LP tanks, the cover. So I was really happy the way that all turned out. Want to wrap things up and got a kind of a sad note and a good note. So the sad note is that this past week we lost Taylor Hawkins, drummer for the Foo Fighters, world renowned drummer, absolutely incredible, super nice guy, at least everything I've ever seen about him. Him and Dave Grohl were like brothers for the past 25 years in the Foo Fighters. Been a huge hit to the drumming community whenever someone of that stature and caliber gets taken away too early. So RIP, Taylor Hawkins, gonna be missed. On a better note, opening day, St. Louis Cardinals coming up this week, April 7th. It's gonna be a great day. We recently reacquired Albert Pujols. He's coming back home to the Cards for one more season. It's gonna be a great year with Yadi behind the plate. We got Waino on the mound and we got Albert hitting DL. So it's gonna be a great year. A lot of good stuff to look forward to. Quite the fan, so look forward to that happening. Even have an ugly hat right here, St. Louis Cardinals. So appreciate you guys stopping in this week. And I'm supposed to say this apparently. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribing, go ahead and do that now. See you guys.